this is expansion foam. I could give you a list of reasons this long to put it inside the walls of your houses, and I could give you a list this long of why you should put it inside your bike. So what is this normally for? Well, it's to fill gaps. It can fill in the gaps around piping, it can insulate, it can make something quieter. We use this all over the inside of Alexander's van to try and keep the noise down and keep it nice and warm in the wintertime. And so we could put it inside a little hole in my bike frame and fill the entire frame with foam, but why? Well, I heard through the grapevine that there are actual race mechanics that will fill bikes or parts of bikes with this stuff to make it quieter. Now, keeping bikes quiet is really important. If your bike is really quiet and you're only hearing the things that are supposed to be happening, the second you hear something is off, you know something's wrong. And in a racing situation, that's important. And I personally like riding with a quiet bike. I like to hear the tire sounds and the cassette instead of things rattling. This is supposed to stop that. And so I guess we should just go in this little port in the bottom and fill my frame with expansion foam. Not so fast. This is the type of thing you really want to think through. Every single forum post I can find on this ends with the community stopping the original poster from filling their bike with expansion foam. And then there's always somebody at the end that's like, hey, if you do decide to do that, can you let us know how it turns out? So the first concern I saw people really worried about was that this stuff was just gonna expand and break the bike frame or somehow weaken it. I'm not worried about that at all, but I'm gonna test that. I have this clear tube here. I'm gonna plug up one end with this here tennis ball. Gonna drill a little hole next to it. And so now we are going to spray expansion foam into here. And what I think is gonna happen is it's gonna work its way up the tube. Ooh. Doesn't appear to be expanding much at all. Looks like you have to keep spraying it in for any expansion to really happen, but let's keep an eye on it for a few minutes. Okay, nothing alarming happened here. In fact, I'm alarmed at how much it didn't expand. And so we're not gonna spend any time on worrying about the bike exploding, not with hardware store expansion foam. But that doesn't mean this is an awesome idea. Let's consider some of the other reasons you wouldn't want your bike frame permanently loaded with expansion foam, starting with internal cable routing. As you've seen in many bikes, cables run through the inside of the frame. If it was filled with foam, it'd be pretty hard to get a new one through. Now this frame already has liners for cable housing, and so if I want to run a shift cable through, it'll just pop out the back, and so we don't have to worry about that one. But if I want to hook up a wired dropper post on this frame, it goes through the down tube, so we're going to install a liner first. Okay, so now there's a tube running from here up into the seat tube, and so if that's surrounded with expansion foam, we can still run a dropper cable. The tube should stay still because it's gonna be surrounded with the expansion foam. So now that we have this bike all prepped to fill with expansion foam, let's talk about the biggest reason why you shouldn't do this. Limited gains. If this stuff is gonna make my bike quieter, it's pretty quiet in the first place. And so to make even an attempt at measuring a difference, we took this bike down the rock garden. We attached a decibel meter to it to get the loudest sound out of the bike. We attached a GoPro so you can hear the audio. Take a listen. Okay, three runs. Bike butted up against here. Try and take the same line. .89.5 max dB. And we got a whole bunch of clips of me just dropping the bike in the shop. Take a listen. And so now, without any further ado, let's fill this thing with foam and see if there's a difference. This stuff expands. Let's leave it for an hour. All right, time to test it, but first, get that out of the way. Get our masking tape off of here. Whew, you can smell it. Inside the part that I ripped out, it's a little gooey, and so we're gonna let it cure for a little while longer. Okay, so first of all, I don't know if I notice a difference. I think it's deader. Let's get it out to the rock garden. Okay, run number one. Decibels. That could be just a coincidence. Okay, run number two. Eighty-five point three. All right, interesting results. Let's go do the indoor drop test. So I've watched all the clips, both of dropping the bike 10 times in succession and riding down the rock garden 3 times. It doesn't sound quieter, it just sounds more dead, but I'm hyper aware of the possibility that I'm just imagining that. Now, the decibel meter is where it gets interesting because I didn't expect this data to be very useful because it's just measuring the loudest sound and telling us what the decibels were. It could be the tire making a popping sound off the rock. It could be a cable slapping. We don't know that it's the actual frame, but both on the drop test in the garage and outside, it's showing an average of 2 fewer decibels, over 2. And this is consistent. Anybody who's tested anything in a scientific way knows this is not conclusive, but it's interesting. Damn. So, did we come to any conclusions today? Or better question would be, did we even learn anything? Well, I'll tell you what I would do different if I were to do this experiment over. First of all, I would weigh everything before and after so we could have a definitive answer to how much weight we added to the bike. Another thing I would have done differently is I would have secured the crank set so that it couldn't move during the drop test because it would have been cool to isolate it. I might have even taken off the chain when going down the rock garden to just isolate that. And so the results are not as perfect as they could be. However, if there is a difference, it's very small. And to get there, you gotta fill your bike with spray foam. It's sticky, it's nasty, it can make running cables difficult in the future, and it's pretty much impossible to undo. It's there. And so in all those forums where the original poster is eventually convinced not to do this, it seems like they're getting sound advice. And so now I've got to dig this expansion foam out of my bottle cage bolt. And I gotta fill all my other bikes with expansion foam. That was awesome. So I don't know, do any of you guys know anything about this? Filling a bike with expansion foam? Do you have anything to add here? I just did this for fun. I heard about it. I wanted to try it and see if there was a big difference. There wasn't. But I hope somebody learned something today. And if not, I hope you at least found this entertaining. And if you're digging what we're doing here on this channel, we've got merch. We've got the new ET shirt where I'm jumping onto the airbag in front of a full moon with my friend Oscar here. And we have wonderfully comfortable jerseys. They're all in the link below. Thanks for riding with me today, and I'll see you next time. What else would I change? Oscar, stop. Stop. No. No. I'll get you a brand new tennis ball. I'm sorry, buddy. I had to use it. Halt. Halt, Frenchie. You may not pass.